first one is xy plane. XY plane. So just x axis, y axis. So this is the region generated by these two lines is called XY plane. So the region is divided into four parts, 1, 2, 3, 4. These four quadrants, they are called XY plane. This X axis, Y axis is dividing the complete region into four parts. So this is quadrant one, already discussed in quadrant one, right? This region, quadrant one. This region quadrant 2, this region quadrant 3, this region quadrant 4. This is called XY plane. If you draw two lines, space will be divided into four parts. This region, this region, this region, this region. These are called quadrants. Right? Representation of point. Any point of a point in of a point px comma y in xy plane. So here, this is called x coordinate, just like an ordered pair. So this x is called x coordinate of P. Y coordinate of P. So in space, whatever the point is there, let us say the point is here. Let us say the point is here. Let us say the point is here. Definition is, from the point we draw perpendiculars, we draw perpendiculars on x-axis and y-axis. From this point, draw perpendicular upon x-axis and perpendicular upon y-axis. Right? Let us say this is A, this is B. From any point, representation means draw perpendiculars upon x-axis upon y-axis. AB are perpendiculars upon x axis and y axis. Now look at this perpendicular distance from P upon x axis. This is called its y coordinate. This length is called y coordinate. And this length is called x coordinate. Right? So x coordinate is nothing but perpendicular distance from P upon x axis. X is nothing but perpendicular distance or y, perpendicular distance from P upon y axis. From P upon y axis. Right? So this x is nothing but x coordinate of this is nothing but perpendicular distance from P upon y axis. right? Y coordinate is nothing but perpendicular distance from P upon x-axis. Right, look at this. Here we got a rectangle. We got a rectangle. OABC. OABC. So if this is x, this will also be x because this is parallel. This is rectangle. If this is x, this will also be x. If this is y, this will also be y. That's why whenever you are representing a point x comma y, they are called rectangular coordinates of px comma y. They are coordinates or rectangular coordinates of px comma y. So definition is x is nothing but perpendicular distance from p upon y axis. Y is nothing but perpendicular distance from p upon x axis. Now how to locate a point? How to locate a point is, look at here. In quadrant 1, point will be there if x greater than 0, y greater than 0. So if x is positive, y is positive. That means OX is there, OY is there. If x is positive, y is positive. So point P lies in quadrant 1. Suppose if x is negative, y is positive. So point will lie here. Point will lie in this quadrant. If x is negative, y is negative. Point will lie in quadrant 3. Look at OX dash, OY dash is there. So x is negative, y is negative. So OX, OY dash. In quadrant 4, all points will have x greater than 0, y less than 0. Right? Suppose if you want to locate any point in the quadrant, suppose let us say, A let us say 2 comma 4, right? On x-axis we will locate 2, x coordinate. So x is positive, that means on OX we will measure the length 2. Look, 2 comma 4 means on positive x-axis we will measure the length 2, and then y is positive. On positive y-axis we will measure the length 4. Right? And we'll form a rectangle like this. Look at it. So like this, we will form a rectangle like this. This point is nothing but P2, 4. So if x is positive, y is positive. X means on positive x-axis measure 2 length. Y is positive means on positive y-axis measure 4 length. And construct a triangle like this. This is nothing but P2, 4. A 2, 4. Let us say B. Let us say -2, 3. So x is negative, y is positive. That means on negative x-axis we will measure 2 length. Like this. -2. On negative x-axis, we will measure 2 length, -2, right? And then 3 length, 1, 2, 3. This is 3. So that therefore we will construct a rectangle like this. Okay. We will construct a rectangle like this. So this point will be, this point will be B. -2, 3. That means on negative x-axis 2 units, towards negative x-axis 2 units, and towards positive y-axis 3 units. So this will become -2, 3. Let us say, -3, 5. Let us say, -3, -5. -3, -5. That means x is negative, y is negative. So it will lie in third quadrant. That means -3 towards negative y, negative x axis. So -3 this side, and then -5 towards negative y axis. Then we will mark this point like this. So this will be the point. So this will be the point C, -3, -5. -3, -5. Right? So towards negative x axis 3 units, towards negative y axis -5 units. Therefore, this point is nothing but -3, -5. Let us say, -3, -4. Look it. X is positive, y is negative. That means in this quadrant it will lie. So three towards positive x axis 3 units, and then towards negative x axis 4 units. 4, this is -4, right? So this will be the point. So this will be the point P, 3, -4. That is how to represent a point in the quadrant. That means this x coordinate, if it is positive towards OX, if it is negative towards OX dash. If y coordinate is positive towards OY, if y coordinate is negative towards OY dash. Like that, we will mark the point wherever required. Now if you look at, perpendicular distance from PX, Y. Look at PX, Y on X, from X axis, from x-axis. That means, suppose a point is there. Perpendicular distance means distance you have to write means modulus y. Look at here, this point is there. What is the perpendicular distance from this point to x-axis? So actually this distance is nothing but 4. So this is x, y. This distance is what? 4. Right? This distance is 4. And also y coordinate is also 4 here. Right? Suppose if you take this one, this distance is nothing but 3. This is positive only. And y coordinate is also 3. Suppose if you look at here, this distance is 5. But y coordinate is what? -5. Y coordinate is what? This is x, y. This is x, y. If he is asking distance of this point to y axis, you have to write modulus y, because this distance we will always write positive. If he asks perpendicular distance, if he asks for any point perpendicular distance from the point x comma y to y axis. We will write modulus y. If y is positive, you will get same thing. Here 4, here 3. Because y is positive. If y is negative, what happens? Here you cannot write minus 5. Perpendicular distance means y coordinate is minus 5 only. But distance, this distance you have to write means modulus of minus 5 we will write. Then it will become 5. Always distance means we will write positive only. That's why from x-axis, whenever perpendicular distance is asked, write modulus y. If y is positive, directly you will get y only. If y is negative also, distance you will get positive. Distance you will get positive. Look at from y-axis is nothing but modulus x. Right? If you look at here, from y-axis means this is the distance. This is 2. This is 2 and x is also 2, positive. That's why distance also 2 you got. Here x is negative. Here x coordinate is negative. But this distance is what? 2 only. But x is what? Minus 2. You cannot write distance as minus 2. That's why modulus x you will write. So here if you look at this distance is what? 3 units. But x coordinate is what? Minus 3. You cannot write distance as minus 3. That means distance equal to modulus of x coordinate. If he asks x coordinate, we will write minus 3 only. But if he wants distance of this point to y axis, we will write modulus x. Right? Perpendicular distance from the point x comma y from x axis is modulus of y coordinate. From y axis is modulus x coordinate. If P x comma y, suppose a point is there, if x comma y is equidistant from coordinate axis, P is like it is equidistant from coordinate axis. That means distance of P, distance of P to x axis is same as distance of P to y axis. Look at equidistant means suppose P is like this. This distance, perpendicular distance to x axis equal to perpendicular distance to y axis, then perpendicular distances will be equal, PA equal to PB. That means what is the condition you have to write is modulus x equal to modulus y. If PX comma y is equidistant from coordinate axis, then condition is modulus x equal to modulus y. That means this distance is modulus y. This distance is what? Modulus x. This is the condition. Number one. Suppose if P lies in quadrant 1 or quadrant 3. Suppose if P lies in quadrant 1 or quadrant 3, then equidistant means what you have to write is x equal to y. Because in quadrant 1, look at, in quadrant 1, x greater than 0, y greater than 0. X greater than 0, y greater than 0. That means modulus x is what when x greater than 0? X. This modulus x will become x. This modulus y will become y. That means x equal to y. Suppose in quadrant 3, what is that? X less than 0, y less than 0. In quadrant 3, if it is equidistant, then this condition, so it will become minus x equal to minus y. Right? Modulus x is what? When x is negative, minus x. Modulus y is what? When y is negative. So this equation will become minus x equal to minus y. That means in that case also x equal to y. That means if the point is equidistant from coordinate axis and if P lies in quadrant 1 or quadrant 3, remember this condition x equal to y. X equal to y. Right? Because in quadrant 1, x greater than 0, y greater than 0. So this will become x, this will become y. X equal to y. If x less than 0, y less than 0, this will become minus x. This will become minus y. Even in that case also, x equal to y. That means if a point is equidistant from coordinate axis and if it lies in quadrant 1 or quadrant 3, write the condition x equal to y. Sahid. ఇందులో ఉన్న అవును ఇప్పుడు ఇది ఉంది కదా ఎక్స్ ఎక్స్ పాజిటివ్ అయితే ఇది ఎక్స్ అంటే ఇక్కడ పాయింట్ చూడు ఒకసారి ఇక్కడ పాయింట్ 2,2 అని ఉందనుకో 2,2 ఈక్విడిస్టెంట్ అంటే అంతే కదా 2,2 అంటే x ఈక్వల్ టు y గా సో ఇక్కడ పాయింట్ p మైనస్ 2, మైనస్ 2 ఉంటుంది ఈవెన్ ఇది x ఇది y x ఈక్వల్ టు y కదా అట్లా మనకి ఒక పాయింట్ కనుక క్వాడ్రంట్ 1 ఆర్ క్వాడ్రంట్ 3 ఇట్ లైస్ వెన్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఈక్విడిస్టెంట్ ఫ్రమ్ కోఆర్డినేట్ యాక్సిస్ x ఈక్వల్ టు y అయింది అన్నమాట అంటే దిస్ x కోఆర్డినేట్ అండ్ y కోఆర్డినేట్స్ బోత్ విల్ బి ఈక్వల్ Next, second point. If P lies in quadrant 2 or quadrant 4, then x equal to minus y. X equal to minus y. And that's all. ఇప్పుడు ఇప్పుడు ఇక్కడ ఉంది పాయింట్ పి ఈక్విడిస్టెంట్ అంటే ఎలా ఉంటుంది ఈ క్వాడ్రంట్ లో పాయింట్ మైనస్ 2,2 మైనస్ 2,2 దిస్ డిస్టెన్స్ ఈస్ 2 దిస్ డిస్టెన్స్ ఈస్ 2 సో లుక్ ఎట్ హియర్ సో ఎక్స్ ఈస్ మైనస్ 2 వై ఈస్ 2 దేర్ ఫోర్ ఎక్స్ ఈక్వల్ టు వాట్ మైనస్ వై సపోజ్ ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఇన్ క్వాడ్రంట్ 4 సో క్వాడ్రంట్ 4 అంటే మనకు పాయింట్ ఎలా ఉంటుంది 2 ఈక్వల్ డిస్టెన్స్ అంటే p దట్ మీన్స్ 2 కామా మైనస్ 2 సో ఇన్ బోత్ కేసెస్ x ఈక్వల్ టు వాట్ మైనస్ y బోత్ విల్ బి ఈక్వల్ అండ్ ఆపోజిట్ సైన్స్ దేర్ ఫోర్ x ఈక్వల్ టు వాట్ మైనస్ y ఆర్ అదర్వైస్ ఇఫ్ యు లుక్ ఎట్ హియర్ నెంబర్ 1 ఇఫ్ యు లుక్ ఎట్ దిస్ ఈక్వేషన్ క్వాడ్రంట్ 1 Quadrant 1 means x, no, quadrant 2. Quadrant 2 means x less than 0, y greater than 0. If x less than 0, modulus will become minus x equal to y. Therefore, this is nothing but x equal to minus y. In quadrant 3, x is positive. And y is negative. So if x is positive, this is x and this is what? Minus y. Therefore, in both cases, either in quadrant 2 or quadrant 3, what is the condition it will satisfy? X equal to minus 5. That means if any point is equidistant from coordinate axis and if it lies in quadrant 1 or quadrant 3, x will be equal to y. If any point is equidistant from coordinate axis, and if it lies in quadrant 2 or quadrant 4, x equal to minus y or x plus y equal to 0. X equal to minus y or x plus y equal to 0. Only when equidistant from coordinate axis. Right? This is the point. Suppose problem will be asked like this. Look, if the point, P A square comma A, point is given, is equidistant from coordinate axis and lies in quadrant 4, then A equal to dash. Let us say it is equidistant from coordinate axis and lies in quadrant 4. That means what it must be? X equal to minus y. That means A square equal to minus A. That means A into A plus 1 equal to 0. So A equal to 0. A equal to minus 1. A equal to minus 1. Right? If you look at here, if A equal to 0, point will become 0 comma 0. Right? This will not be in quadrant. This will be on x axis or y axis. Quadrant will strictly means this A equal to minus 1. A equal to minus 1 means P. P 1 comma minus 1. So therefore A equal to minus 1. Quadrant 4 means leaving these lines strictly in quadrant 4. In quadrant 4 strictly here. That means other than these lines, this origin means will be here. Strictly means in quadrant 4 inside. In quadrant 4 asked means inside, not on the lines. Therefore, if A equal to 0, this will become 0 comma 0. Therefore, answer is only minus 1. Quadrant 4 means strictly in that, not on the lines, borders. Like that, whenever equidistant from coordinate axis is given. Right? So, next. For some theorems, proofs are necessary, not necessary. That will take a lot of time. For some theorems, you remember just that theorem. Okay. Because from childhood onwards, you know this. So, AB distance is nothing but distance between two points. Right? So, that is. Look it. Suppose any point on x-axis, if a point lies on x-axis, it will be of the form x comma 0. Its y coordinate will be 0. If it lies on OX, then x greater than 0, other than origin. If it lies on OX, x will be greater than 0. Any point on OX will be of form x comma 0, where x greater than 0. That means 2 comma 0, 3 comma 0, like that points will be on x-axis. Suppose if a point lies on negative x, that means it will be of form P x comma 0, where x is less than 0. That means minus 3 comma 0, minus 4 comma 0, those type of points will lie on negative x-axis. If a point lies on positive y-axis, it will be of the form, when you want to take a point on y-axis, It will be of form 0, comma y, where y is positive. If y is positive, it lies here. 0, comma 2, 0, comma 3, 0, comma 5. Like that, those points. If a point lies on negative y-axis, it will be of form 0, comma y, where y is negative. That means points on x-axis must be taken of the form x, comma 0. Points on y-axis must be taken of the form 0, comma y. Suppose if y coordinates, look at them. If y coordinates of two points are there, A comma B, are equal. Suppose if y coordinates of A comma B are equal, then AB, this line segment, if I am writing like this, this is line segment AB, will be parallel to x-axis. Will be parallel to x-axis. Look, suppose for example, A 1 comma 3, B 4 comma 3. Let us take an example. Suppose two points are like this. Their y coordinates are equal. Their y coordinates are equal means this 1 comma 3 means how you will mark this is 1. This is 3. How we will mark this? This is A. This is A. This is 1 comma 3. This is 1 comma 3. Right? Suppose 4 comma 3 positive. That means 2, 3, 4. This is 4 and 3. So what is the point? This point. That means this point is what? 4 comma 3. That means look at this line segment AB, because y coordinates are equal means these distances will be equal to 3. This distance is 3, this distance is 3. That means the line joining AB, line segment, will be parallel to x-axis. Like that, if two points are such that their y coordinates are same, the line segment AB bar will be parallel to x-axis, because these distances will be equal. That means it will be parallel to x-axis. Similarly, we can say if x coordinates are same, then AB bar will be parallel to y-axis. Line joining those two points will be parallel to y-axis. Suppose take an example. Suppose two points are there like this. Right, A 2 comma 3, B 2 comma minus 4. A 2 comma 3, we will mark. This is 2. This is 2. And then 3 means positive side. That means this is the point A. So this is the point A. This is 3. A 2 comma 3. Right. So this is the point. B 2 comma minus 4 means this is 2. Minus 4. So this is B. This is B. 2 comma minus 4. Look at. This will be parallel to y-axis, because this distance is 3. This distance is 3. Therefore, this line will be parallel to y-axis. If x coordinates are same, the line joining AB will be parallel to y-axis. If y coordinates are same, then it will be parallel to x-axis, AB bar. Like that, whenever two points are given, you have to make an observation of these two points. Whenever I am writing like this, just value this is looking. Whenever I am writing A, B, from here, whenever I am writing between two vertical bars, A, B, C, D, this is nothing but a value. How to calculate is looking. This into this, write like this arrow. This into this, minus this into this. This is just a value. This is called determinant. Right? After that, you will have a chapter. For the time being, whenever I am writing like this, it indicates this value, AD, this into this first. This into this minus this into this. AD minus BC. This value is denoted like this. Whenever you will get this, you write this. So, keep an arrow from here to here. Keep an arrow from here to here. This into this minus this into this. Just value, remember this. After the determinant chapter is there, there you will get. Suppose like this, look at 2, 5, 7, 6. Like this it is there. Like this it is there. This way, this means this into this minus this into this. 6 into 12, 6 into 2, 12, minus 7 into 5, 35. It can be positive or negative, whatever the value you will get, you write minus 23, like that, whenever you will get, like this. Right, next. Area of triangle. Area of triangle ABC. Area of triangle ABC. Where A. What is this you know? Where A is this. B is this. C is this. Whenever you know the three vertices. Whenever you know the three vertices ABC. You write area of triangle ABC, I will denote by delta. I will denote it by delta if coordinates are known. Look at this formula. Half into modulus of. MOD means modulus. Just I am writing like modulus of. This is the formula for calc x1 minus x2. Y1 minus Y2, X1 minus X3, Y1 minus Y3, Y1 minus Y3. Modulus, this value you can get positive or negative. If you write modulus, it will always become positive because area of triangle is always what? Positive. So, this is the formula for area. So, when coordinates are known, three coordinates are known, to calculate area, use this formula. Find this value like this, and then write modulus. Modulus, suppose you got minus 11. Half into modulus minus 11, that means 11 by 2. Suppose, take one example, A1, 2. B 3 4 C 5 comma 7. Let us say area of triangle ABC half into modulus. This determinant you write x1 minus x2, that means 1 minus 3, 1 minus 3, y1 minus y2, 2 minus 4. is 1 minus 3, 2 minus 4, x1 minus x3, that means 1 minus 5, 2 minus 7. That means half into modulus. Write these values. Minus 2, minus 2, minus 4, minus 5. So this into this, minus this into this. That means, so modulus, value you write. Minus 5 into minus 2, 10. Minus this into this means minus 8. Half into modulus. This is modulus. So 10 minus 8 means this is already positive. So half into modulus 2 is what?
1.
That is the answer. Right? If you got negative here, suppose minus 5 you got. Modulus minus 5. That means half into modulus 5 means 5. Like that. Whenever you know 3 vertices, then to calculate area of triangle ABC. Points lying on
same line
are called collinear points. Collinear points. That means if on a same line, three points are lying. Then they are called collinear points. So look, if A, B, C are collinear, then condition you write area of triangle ABC equal to 0. If the points are given collinear, when they will be collinear means find the area of triangle ABC. If it will become 0, look at, if they lie on a line, what is area of triangle ABC? 0, right? Because they will not form a triangle. So area of triangle ABC is what? 0. Just immediately for those points, calculate area. If it will become 0, then they will be collinear. Or otherwise, there is one more condition.
AX1Y1.
This is one procedure. Do like that.
CX3Y3.
If they are collinear, then use the condition this.
Y2 minus Y1 divided by X2 minus X1 equal to Y2 minus Y3 divided by X2 minus X3.
So this condition also you can make use of. Just nothing is there. A is there, B is there. Slope of AB is this. If you know. Slope of BC is this. If they are collinear, they represent same line. Slope of AB equal to slope of BC. Or otherwise, equate triangle ABC equal to 0. You will get the same condition. Right? This you can use. If you don't remember this one, write area of triangle ABC equal to 0 to check whether they are collinear or not. Next.
Area of an equilateral triangle.
Remember this one.
Area of an equilateral triangle.
You will get this more. Of side is root 3 by 4 a square. So side A is there, this is root 3 by 4 a square. Of altitude H, of altitude H is, look at, of altitude H is, formula is H square divided by root 3. That means if you know the altitude in the triangle, this is A, B, C, this is altitude. If this length you know, this altitude length you know, then H square divided by root 3. In equilateral triangle, any altitude length will be equal only. All the three altitudes will be of equal length. If any altitude is given, H square by root 3, area of equilateral triangle. Next up. Area of polygon. Area of polygon having n vertices. Having n vertices. A1, x1, y1, b, x2, y2. C, A1, A2, A3, AN. N vertices are there. Suppose 4 vertices means quadrilateral like that. Area of triangle how to find is area equals to, how to write is, look at, half into first coordinate is there A, right, like this, look at, x1 y1 like this, first coordinate in first column x1 y1, then x2 y2, like this. Second one, and so on. Next, the column x3, y3, and so on. Last, xn, yn, xn, yn. And then, after an is over, again you write x1, y1. Again you write x1, y1. Right? First column x1, y1. Second, x2, y2, x3, y3, till n columns. And finally, you write x1, y1. This means that, look. Area equals to half into modulus of. Modulus, whatever the value, how to calculate the value I am writing. Suppose I will tell an example of how to. I will tell an example of how to write. Area of pentagon. Area of pentagon, that means 5 sides will be there. Whose vertices are. Whose vertices are 4, 1, 3, 6, -5, 1, -3, -3, -0. Like this it is there. 4, 1, 3, 6, -5, 1. -3, -3, and -3, 0. Pentagon this is. Right? What you have to do is, if you want to calculate area equals to half into, look at how to write, modulus of first 4, 1. Look at 4 comma 1. This is 3, 6, second column. Then minus 5, 1. Minus 5, 1. Then minus 3. Minus 3. Minus 3, minus 3, minus 3, 0, over 5 written, and then you write 4, 1. And then you write 4, 1. Look at half into modulus of, first take this 2 by 2, this 2. This 2 means, you know how to write the determinant, look at 24 minus 3. This, look at this. This into this minus this into this. So 24 minus 3, 21, this plus, for this only, add all these and then modulus, 6 into 4 minus 3 into 1, 21, so next this and this, 1 into 3, 3 minus of minus 30, so therefore you will get 3 plus 30, that means 33. This is over second one. Next, this one, these two. So, minus 3 into minus 5, 15 plus 3. 15 plus 3 means what? 18. Right? So, this into this, next one, this one. 0, this into this, 0, minus of minus 3 into minus 3. That means minus 9. Add all these and write modulus, not for individual one. Next, these two, 1 into minus 3, minus 3, minus 0 into 4, minus 3, like that. So, half into modulus of, what is the value you will get? What is the value? Look at 34, 54. 54, 62, 72, 72 minus 12, that means 60. So, modulus 60 means 60 divided by 2, that means 30. After adding this, you write modulus. Here, positive you got. Suppose after adding all these things, you got minus 60, then modulus minus 60. Like that, if more than for anything, any quadrilateral, any polygon having more than three vertices, triangle also you can write like this. But triangle formula is there. Triangle means only three. X1, Y1, X2, Y2, X3, Y3, then X1, Y1. Then only you will get. But any triangle you can write, quadrilateral you can write, any polygon having n vertices. Suppose quadrilateral has well-designed formula. Area of quadrilateral is there. You can write like this or you can use this formula. Area of quadrilateral A, B, C, D. Where A, X1, Y1. B, X2, Y2. C, X3, Y3. D, X4, Y4. Right? Formula you can write like this. Half into modulus of this determinant. X1 formula is X1 minus X3, Y1 minus Y3, X2 minus X4, X2 minus X4, Y2 minus Y4. This formula. After calculating this, write modulus. You can write like this or you can use this formula also. X1, Y1, X2, Y2, X3, Y4, X4, Y4, then X1, Y1. You can calculate by using this also. Or you can use directly this one. This is well-designed formula. You can do it in any manner. Like that, area of quadrilateral or area of any triangle, quadrilateral, polygon, like that area. Look at next. to get out. Look at, let 3 points are there. Let P, comma A, comma B are collinear. Are collinear. That means these 3 points will lie on the same line. Will lie on the same line. Collinear means. Then the ratio in which P divides AB bar, right? The ratio in which P divides AB bar is, whenever it is given like this, it means that P divides AB bar is nothing but PA is to PB. Whenever he asks what is the ratio in which P divides AB bar, first point is A and then B means P to A, P to first point, E to P is to P is to P to last point. The ratio in which P divides AB is PA is to PB, it is called, right? Suppose, look at, P divides AB means PA is to PB. Let A x1 y1, B x2 y2. Let A x1 y1, B x2 y2. The point P divides internally. Internally in the ratio M is to N. In the ratio M is to N divides here AB bar. Suppose it is given like this, right? That means P is dividing AB bar internally means P lies inside of AB and P divides AB bar in the ratio M is to N means, what is the meaning? Okay. P to starting point is to P to ending point. That means this is given. And P is lying internally, look at, AB is there. Collinear means it can lie on the line anyway. Right? What he has told? P is dividing in the ratio M is to N internally. Internally means whatever the ratio is there, P divides AB in the ratio M is to N, meaning is that PA is to PB is given M is to N. Now he is telling it is dividing internally. That means P lies internally. P lies internally. That means this means that P divides this line segment length, whatever it is there, in the ratio M is to N. PA is there, PB is there. This ratio is nothing but M is to N. M is to N. That means in that case, if this is X1, Y1 and this is X2, Y2, right? And this is the ratio M is to N, then P point, coordinates of P will be written like this. Look at M into, this is M is to N, M into that side X2, M X2, M into that side X2 plus N into this side, divided by, remember this theorem, proof not necessary, mx2 plus nx1 divided by m plus n my2 plus ny1 divided by m plus n. So the coordinates of a point which divides AB bar internally in the ratio m is to n means this coordinates of the point will be mx2 plus nx1 divided by m plus n. So these are the coordinates of points which divides. First of all, you have to understand that what is the ratio in which P divides AB. Whenever it is dividing, AB means this PA is to PB is this given. But where P lies, he is telling, P lies internally. That means mark P, and what is given, PA is to PB is M is to N, not this length is M. Look at this length is just MK. This length is not M. Where K is any constant, this length is MK. This length is NK, not this length is M, this length is N. Right? This is MK, this is NK, such that PA length is MK, PB length is MK, PA is to PB is what? M is to N, like that. Their length ratio is given, not this length is M, this length is N. Just their length ratio means this is MK, this is NK. Then PA is to PB is what? M is to N. So this is the one. Suppose number two. In this case, midpoint of AB. Midpoint of AB. Midpoint means, suppose let us say if P is midpoint, that means 1 is to 1. 1 is to 1. So that means this PA equal to PB. What is PA is to PB? 1 is to 1. If midpoint, if a line segment is there, midpoint of AB is nothing but x1 plus x2 by 2, comma, y1 plus y2 by 2. Y1 plus y2 by 2. That means this divides internally in the ratio 1 is to 1. Internally in the ratio 1 is to 1. Keep m equal to 1, n equal to 1. You will get midpoint. So like this is internally. This is internally. P divides AB bar externally in the ratio M is to N. M is to N. Suppose let us say P divides externally in the ratio. So whatever it is there, P divides AB in the ratio M is to N means, here also P2 starting point length, it is to P2 ending point length. This is M is to N. This is M is to N. Externally or internally, it divides AB bar means this PA is to PB is given M is to N. Right? Now if you mark that, he is telling that PB. Right? This is complete line. Extend this. Right? So now you have to mark P such that PA is to PB equal to M is to N. Now P is lying externally. Look it. I am marking it can lie here. Meaning is that PA length is there. From P to A length is there. From P to A length you calculate. From P to B length you calculate. Those lengths must be in the ratio M is to N. That means here meaning is that suppose that side P is there, right? So that means that PA, this is MK, right? PA, this length is MK. So then PB length is NK. Right? So look at the ratio. PA length is what? NK. PB length is what? NK. In the previous case is also M is to N only. But P is internally. PA is to PB. So externally means it will lie outside AB. That side P is lying, let us say. That means PA length is MK. PB length is NK. Their length ratio is what? M is to N. Suppose it can lie like this also. AB is there. Extend this. P. Now, here meaning is that PA is MK, this length, and PB is NK. Then also it is possible. Then also it is possible. Internally or externally, whatever it is, ratio is given means P to A is to P to B is given. Now, internally means we will mark internally. Externally means we will mark externally. It can lie externally like this. Right, it can lie externally like this, P that side can lie, this side also it can lie, no problem. The meaning is that P divides AB means PA is to PB equal to M is to N. If externally is given, we will mark outside AB. If internally is given, we will mark inside AB. Like that, no need to confuse. Whenever P divides AB is given, you have to understand that PA is to PB is given. Right? So this is, this point, coordinates of the point in any case is, look at, M is to N. M is to N means this is X1, Y1. This is X1, Y1. This is X2, Y2. Right? So this is X1, Y1. P divides AB in the ratio M is to N externally means M into, look at, AB. M into right side point mx2 minus nx1 divided by m minus n my2 minus ny1 divided by m minus n. This is the formula to calculate the point which divides AB bar externally. In AB bar, A must be taken x1, y1, B must be taken x2, y2. Then m into always right side point. Minus n into left side point divided by m minus n, always will write m into right side 1 minus n into left side 1. M into right side 1 minus n into left side 1 divided by m minus n. This is the one. Right, now look at on this section formula how it will be. Suppose let A minus 1 comma 4. Here in this case, look at them. Here in this case, there are two terminologies. P divides. There are two terminologies. Externally in M is to N. One terminology is this. We will say that P divides externally in the ratio M is to N, or another terminology is P divides AB bar externally. P divides AB bar in ratio M is to minus N. This is also called. If M is to minus N is written, no need, they will not write externally here. Right? M is to minus N. 2 is to minus 3 told. That means ratio is negative only. That means he will give externally in the ratio M is to N. This is same as P divides AB bar in ratio M is to minus N. Same terminology. This indirectly he will give like this. P divides AB bar in the ratio 2 is to minus 3 given. You have to understand that P divides AB bar externally in the ratio 2 is to 3. Instead of giving like this, he will tell that AB bar in the ratio M is to minus N. So this and this are of same meaning. Instead of giving externally, he will give in the ratio M is to minus N. That also same, we have to understand that. Suppose let A minus 1 comma 4, B 2 comma 3. Two points are given. One. divides AB bar. Follow carefully. Internally, in ratio 2:3. 2:3. Right? So 2:3 like this. Look at. So that means, so what is given? AB bar. A is starting point. So that means he has given PA is to PB is 2:3. P2 starting point is 2. That means A is like this. Generally, B is this. So 2, 3. So P is dividing internally. That means this. So 2:3. Right? So P point is internally. That means, so MX2. Right? MX2. That means 2 × 2, 4. Plus NX1, 3 × −1, −3. Divided by 2 + 3, 5. 2 + 3, 5. MY2, 6. MY2 plus 3 × 4, 12. Divided by 5. So what is the P point? 1 / 5. Coordinates. So this is 17/18/5. So this is, these are the coordinates of the point which divides internally in the ratio of 2:3. Now look at, scenario is here. What you have to understand is, look at here. So P divides in the ratio 2:3. That means P will be internally. That means you have to understand that AB will be 5 parts sum. AB will be 5. Look at here. PA by PB. This is 2/3. So PA is, let us say, 2K. Understand this. You have to go the problems like this, in this manner. So PA is 2K. That means PA is 2 parts. PB is 3 parts, right? So that means P you are marking here. So AB will be 5 parts sum. Look at, P is internally. So PA 2 parts, 2K, PB 3 parts. AB will be what? 5 parts. This is 2 parts of AB. This is 3 parts of AB, right? Now, what I am doing is AB is 5 parts. I am dividing into 5 parts this. Look at, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Right? I am dividing because PA is 2 parts. Each part is K. Right? PB is 3K. Right? This is 2 parts. This is 3 parts. So AB is what? 5 parts. Now I have divided 5 parts. Each part is K. Each part is K. Each part is K. Now AM. Now P is where? P is 2 parts. Look at. 2 parts means P will be here. Right? So this length is what? This length 2K. This length is what? 3K. Right? Suppose we have found out what is this point. Without that, you can easily calculate. You can easily calculate what is PA length and what is PB length. PA plus PB is what? PA plus PB is nothing but AB. PA means 2K, 3K, 5K is nothing but root of distance. So distance between this and this is what? −1, −2 whole square. This is 9. Look at, −1, −2 whole square. This is 9. 4 − 1, 4 − 3 whole square. That means this is root 10. What is K? What is K? Root 10 divided by 5. Suppose PA length you want. PA is how many parts? 2K. That means 2√10/5. So PB is how much length? PB is how much? PB is 3K. That means 3√10/5. like that. Of course, you have found out the point, and then you can calculate what is PA, what is PB. Point calculate. Now, scenario is here. This by this is 2 by 3 means take PA as 2K, PB as 3K. So, totally AB will be, this is 2 parts. This is 2 parts, 2K means 3 parts. So, AB will be 5 parts. You divide into 5 parts. 5. Each part is K. So, where you will mark P? 2K means this is P. That means in this case, P will be nearer to A. Because look at PA distance is what? PA is 2 parts, PB is 3 parts. You can say that internally will be there. And to which it will be nearer, P point? To A it will be nearer. To B it will be farther. That means this distance PA, whatever it is there, that is less than PB. That means P will be nearer to A than B. So in this case, P will be nearer, internally only it will be there. P will be nearer to A and will be farther from B. Understood? So always whenever the ratio is there, you take 2K, 3K. That means 5 parts AB, divide into 5 parts. Mark the point in 2 parts. This is P, like that. Internally, you will calculate the point MX2 plus NX1 divided by. The meaning is here, internally means it will divide these 5 parts into 2 parts this, into 2, 3 parts that. Suppose P divides. What is the meaning of this? P divides AB bar externally in the ratio 2:3. Externally, P divides AB bar in the ratio 2. Here also same thing. P2 starting point is to P2 ending point. It is what? 2:3. So PA by PB is nothing but 2 by 3. That means AB we will mark like this. AB, look at. B 2, 3. Look at. P you can mark that side of this side, but it is clear here. PA is 2 parts, PB is 3 parts. Which is lesser one? So P will be nearer to A than B. P will be nearer to A than B. That means this side. Look at P, if I mark here, PA will be this 2 parts, PB will be 3 parts. That means PA is lesser, right? PA is lesser means on A side you mark that. Which one is lesser? That side you mark. There, here P will be there. Actual meaning is P will lie here. Because look at that. PA is 2 parts, PB is 3K. That means PA will be lesser. If you mark A here, PA will be more, right? That's why P will lie on this side. Right, the meaning is here PA, look at here, PA is 2K, PB is 3K, here also, look at this, PA is 2K, this PB is 3K, these lengths ratio is 2:3, now look at, this is A, this is B, direct formula, M is to N. So MX2 means what? 2 into 2, 4. MX2 minus NX1 minus 3 into minus 1 divided by 2 minus 3. So MX2 minus NX1 divided by M minus N. MY2, that means 2 into 3 minus N Y1, 3 into 4 divided by 2 minus 3. This point is what? So 4 plus 3, 7 by minus 1. That means minus 7. This is what? 6 minus 12. 6 minus 12 means minus 6. Minus 6 divided by minus 1. So therefore 6. This is the point. So directly we will find out by using this ratio. Right? Here meaning is, look at here. This only I am pre-drawing here. Look at here. This meaning is here. This meaning is, look at here. This is 2. This is 2 parts and this is 3k. That means PB is 3 parts. Look at how to mark the point is. This only you have, PB is what? 3k, 3 parts. PB is 3 parts divided into 3 parts. Look at 1, 2, 3. This is k. This is k, this is k. This will be 3k. This will be 3k. Now a is what? 2k. A will be like this. Look at this is 2k. 2 parts. Right? This is 3 parts. This is 3 parts. Right? Look at here. PB is 3 parts. I have divided into 3 parts. This. So k, k, k. Where a will be 2k. That means a is here. Look at AB is this. AB is this. Right? P will lie here. P will lie here. That means P will be nearer to A. Nearer to A. Farther to B. Right? If you look at here, P, suppose if you want to calculate A, that suppose PA minus, look at here, PB minus PA. PB minus PA is what? AB. PB, look at this, PB minus PA is AB. PB is what? PB is 3K minus PA is what? 2K. That means this AB we have calculated, root 10. So therefore, K is what? Root 10. So therefore, what is PA length here? PA length is nothing but, PA length is nothing but 2 root 10. PB length is nothing but 3 root 10. Like that. Without calculating the point also, you can easily find out. Of course, you have found out the point. You can find distance between PA and then distance between PB. The same thing you will get. Here, that is external division. Meaning, suppose take one problem. P, comma, A, comma, B are collinear. They lie on same line. Given that PA divided by AB. PA divided by AB equal to 3 by 4. 3 by 4. A is minus 1, comma, 4. B is 2,3. Find P. Look at this problem. Nothing he told. It lies internally, nothing is told. It lies externally, nothing is to be told. But given that PA by AB is 3 by 4. Look at this. PA by AB is 3 by 4. That's only it is given. Right? He has nothing told. P divides internally, P divides externally. So, look at, in this case, what I am doing is, PA, let us say 3K. AB, let us say 4K. Right? AB, let us say 4K. Now, look at, I am marking AB length first. AB, bigger length is there, I am marking AB. AB is 4 parts. I am dividing it to 4 parts. Right? Each part is k. This length is 4k given. I am marking. After that, I will mark Where is P possibility? Where is P possibility? He has given that. So PA equal to 3K. 3K means one possibility is P can lie here. So PA is 3K means K, K, K. Internally means it will lie like this. Internally means it will lie like this. One possibility. One possibility. Right? Internally it will lie means it will lie like this. This is 3K. So 3 is 2. AB is 4K. PA is 3K. That means in this case P divides AB bar in what is the ratio? PA is to PB. PA is to PB means PA is 3K. PB means K. That means 3K is to K. That means it divides internally in the ratio 3 is to 1. Now this is X1, Y1. This is X2, Y2. MX2. This is X1, Y1. This is X2, Y2. So therefore MX2, MX2. 3 into 2. MX2 plus NX1 plus N into minus 1 divided by 3 plus 1 comma MY2. MY2 means 3 into 3 plus NY1 divided by 3 plus 1. So one possibility is like this. So that means this is 6 minus 1. 5 divided 6 minus 1, 5 divided by 4. 5 divided by 4. 9 plus 4, 13. 13 divided by 4. Like this it can lie. Not necessary that it can lie like that only. He has not told internally. So again, one more possibility I am writing. AB is there. AB. How many parts? 4 parts. Divide into 4 parts. So each one is K. Each one is K. Like that. Divided into 4 parts. Right? PA is 3K means. PA is 3K means. So look it. Internally I have already marked. Externally also it can lie. It can lie this side. Look it. I am marking 3 parts like this. So the same K. This is K. This is K. This is K. This side also it can lie. This is K. This is K. This is K. Like this also. Look it. If it lie, it cannot lie here. Otherwise what happens? PA will become more. PA is less now. So that means this side only it will lie. So this is one part length is there. Na? This is one part K. This is one part K. This is one part K. So P can lie like this also. If it lies like this also, PA is 2. PB is what? PA means 3K is 2. Is what is that? PA is to AB, AB. If it is like this also, PA is to AB is what? 3 is to 4 only. This condition is satisfied here. This condition is satisfied. It can, P can lie like this also. Now look at P. Now P divides externally AB. What is PA is to PB? That means P divides now. P divides AB bar externally in ratio. In what ratio it is dividing? PA is to PB. P divides AB externally in the ratio PA is to PB. What is this PA? 3K is to PB means 7K. That means it can lie like this also. 0.3 is to 7. That means now in this case P is dividing AB externally in the ratio 3 is to 7. Now this point you find out this point. So therefore I am writing here. P means this is M, this is N. This is X1, Y1. This is X2, Y2. M, X2. 3 into 2. This is M, X2 minus n x1 divided by 3 minus 7. P can be like this also. My2 means 3 into 3 minus 7 into y1 divided by 3 minus 7. That means P point can be, if you look at here, 6 plus 7 means 13 divided by minus 4. Minus 13 by 4, comma. Look. So this is 9. So 9 minus 28. So 9 minus 28 means minus 19 divided by minus 4. Minus 19 divided by minus 4. That means P can be like this if it lies externally. Then also PA by AB is what? 3 by 4. P can be like this. If it lies internally, P will be like this. If nothing is given, it is given like this. It can lie internally or it can lie externally. Right? You take like this. PA is 3K, AB is 4K. AB divide into 4 parts. Now you have to mark P such that PA is 3 parts, 3K. 1, 2, 3. This is P. PA is 3K like this. After that, next. AB is 4K. Now P 3 parts, this side you mark. This 3K. Then also PA is to AB is what? Same only. So that means P divides externally AB in the ratio. PA is to PB. That means 3 is to 7. Like that. If you mark like this points, it will become easy. Multiple answer correctly, he can give the answer. Just this length ratio is 3 by 4. You have to mark P like that. Okay. Look at next problem. Let capital R 15 comma 20, this is one point, divides PQ bar, line segment PQ bar, where P3 comma 6 and Q externally in 3:5 ratio. Find Q. Look at amazing. Find Q. So R point divides PQ in the ratio 3:5. That means RP divided by RQ is nothing but 3/5. Look at here. R divides PQ means RP divided by RQ is 3/5. Now I am marking, look at, the bigger one RQ is there. First I am marking RQ. Look at, RP, let us say, RP, how to mark is, this RQ is 5K. Bigger one you mark first, RQ. So I am marking RQ. The problem, the way of doing is RQ. Right, R must lie externally to PQ. First, I will mark RQ. RQ is 5K. I am dividing it to 5 parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Each one is KM. Just mark like this. right? This is the one. So now P must be definitely inside, because R is, P must be definitely inside. So RP is what? RP is what? 3K. RP is 3K means where it will be 1, 2, 3. So this is P. Look at R divides PQ externally. So like this scenario will be. Right? Now what he has given? R he has given. R he has given 15, 20. P he has given 3, 6. Now he is asking Q. Clearly Q divides. Q divides RP externally. From the diagram it is very clear. So because these two points you know, these two points you know. So you can calculate what is Q. Now you can say that Q divides RP bar, let us say. RP bar externally. Externally in the ratio QR. QR is to QP. Q divides RP. I have told RP first. RQR. This is QR is to QP. So QR is what? QR is how much? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5K is to QP is what? 2K. That means 5 is to 2. 5 is to 2 externally. What is R here? 15, 20. P is what is this? 3, 6. 3, 6. In the ratio 5 is to 2. So that means MX2. MX2 means 5 into 3. 15. Minus nx1. Nx1 means 5 into 3, 15 minus 2 into 15. 30 divided by 5 minus 2. 5 minus 2, comma. Right? My2. 5 into 6, 30 minus ny1. 2 into 20, 40. Divided by 5 minus 2. So this is nothing but. So what you will get? This is minus 15. Minus 15 divided by 3. So this is which point? Q. So minus 15 divided by 3. This is minus 10 divided by 3. Like that. If you do like this, it will become easy. Clearly Q you want, these two you know, Q divides externally, RP in the ratio, QR is to QP. That case you know, you can easily write the, what is the ratio, 5 is to 2. Further, what I have done is, this RQ bigger length is there, I have marked that and divided into 5 parts, bigger length. And then I can mark what is P, 3K, this, you can clearly know, clearly given R divides PQ externally. So where P lies inside only? So like this. Last problem. Just 1 minute over. 1 minute. 1 minute. Last problem. In triangle ABC, A 5, 6, and centroid 2, 3. Then midpoint is dash. Look at our last problem. This is A, this is B. Right? So you know that this is the median. let us say midpoint. This is the median. So centroid divides the median in the ratio 2:1 internally. So A5, 6 given. So centroid 2, 3 given. Now look at this. A is there, G is there, D divides AG externally. D divides AG bar externally. Externally in the ratio DA is to DG. DA is to DG. DA is what? How many parts? 1 + 2. T part DA means this is one part, this is two parts. Three parts are there. 3:2 DG one part. 3:1 externally. That means A5, 6. G2, 3. This is x1, y1. This is x2, y2. You have to find a point which divides this and this. Externally in the ratio 3:1. MX2, 6. Minus NX1, 5. Divided by 3 - 1. MY2 means 3 × 3, 9. Minus NY1, 6 divided by 3 - 1. This is 1 divided by 2, 3 divided by 2. That is the answer. Okay, now? Thank you all of you. Okay, now? Thank you all of you. Have a nice day.